Early in the 20th century, these motion pictures of the great white fleet of the United States Navy were seen throughout the world. Here, years earlier, President Theodore Roosevelt comes aboard the Kearsarge. Roosevelt's personality became familiar around the world with the help of the motion picture. Motion pictures such as these of the first race for the Vanderbilt Cup were exciting novelties in 1903. Only a handful of years earlier, motion in pictures was only a dream. This film will describe some of the events leading to the perfection of motion pictures. Down through the ages, man has sought to record his deeds and his actions in art. First, on the walls of his cave dwellings. Later, in relief, on the walls of his temples. Although man could record the impression of motion in his art, he could not reproduce motion for the unimaginative spectator. In fact, only an artist could record pictures at all. The Florentine genius Leonardo da Vinci, whose Mona Lisa alone immortalized his name in the arts, documented the phenomenon of the camera obscura, a dark room in which anyone could trace the outlines of nature. The camera obscura, the basic instrument of all photography, was used as early as the 11th century by the Arabian astronomer al-Hasan, who employed it in the study of eclipses. Giovanni della Porta, a 16th century Neapolitan writer, entertained guests with natural magic, as he called his application of the camera obscura. In a way, he was the first projectionist. However, that title may belong to Athanasius Kircher, a 17th century German priest and scientist, who developed this catoptrican theater, a theater of mirrors, using sunlight to reflect pictures on a wall. Kircher's book,